Well, thank you, Fabio, for coming and talking to us today. You're the link convener for Inclusive Education Network. Yep. But you could tell me, what's the main idea that brings people to your network?
Yes, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for this interview. I think the roots of our network has been historically in special education. And especially the focus was historically on disability. However, in the last few years, we spread our interest, our other subjects as ethnicity, gender, social class, relationship between home and school, family, and these issues has increasingly grow as an interest in our network. So the network is expanding in that sense from the core of the disability studies.
And what's the main topics you've been discussing at the conference here?
It is really difficult to summarize as if I can say that what are the main topic of the inclusive network today, I think this is diversity. We work more and more on diversity, so we pay special attention to this and all its nuances and that's the most important point. Of course, disability has still a large amount of presentation and symposia, etc. But we also have very interesting contribution, for example, about the role the social environment plays in getting children access to school, to kindergarten, etc. Or the comparison between countries about how inclusion is working and so on, in very different dimension, very different layers, I should say.
And then how does this different topics you're discussing and your network as a whole, how does it contribute to European educational research?
In agreement, absolutely, with the idea of ER of supporting high quality educational research in connection with the development of a relationship between education and society. And this part about education and society, it is very important for our network, because we are working on what has been called in many European documents the social dimension. So, and as for example in higher education, as to guarantee access and success of students to higher education. We are actively working on, especially now, on filling the gap between policies and practices, because we have really very good statements and research about how to improve the system at all level, from kindergarten to higher education, but we have also to think about how this policy can be can have an input on the practices implemented, in a sense.
Now, I'm sure you know there's 33 different networks in ERA. What makes yours unique amongst all these?
This is a very large network. I mean, in terms of number, this year we have almost 300 contributions. We offer a robust framework to explore and value diversity. That's our uniqueness. So, in that sense, we are unique in welcoming very different contribution on that. For example, we have average, we are always, every year we have a fair amount of session, for example, on teachers' attitude on inclusive education in terms of their relation on their activity, or for example, we have a session on the effect of social inequalities to the access to education, and more recently we have had very good, and I'm proud of that, very good amount of proposal on refugee education and symposia, etc. This is the uniqueness, is not on the in a special content, but it's the way we are able to manage all this diversity.
And do you have any other, are you connected to any other groups or associations?
Yeah. So we have cooperation, step of cooperation with other networks, like, for example, children out of risk and rural education, social justice and intercultural education, health and well-being, communities, family, intercultural education number 20, and also recently with the environmental education number 30. So that's really important.
So when it comes to January and people are submitting proposals,
yeah,
and they're thinking, well, how do I write this proposal? What do you look for in a proposal?
We exclude all the contributions that are not mentioning or having a connection with inclusion, of course. But we cannot exclude, for example, presentation. There are, for example, we have a couple of presentation on sexuality. But inclusion education also involves sexuality. There is not a network that are working exactly on that. There is a general, recently 33. I'm happy to have this new, very happy to have the new network in ESER. But we are welcoming also this kind of proposal, even though it is not the, let's say, average proposal. The average proposal, of course, tend to be on teacher education, on school, and the way the teacher manage inclusion in school, etc. This is, I mean, 80% is about that, or the surrounding environment.
Here's a personal question to you, Fabio.
All right.
What do you like about ECER?
It's a fantastic place. I mean, you come up to on Friday, I'm personally exhausted. And by I'm happy to be exhausted, because what I like is the way ECER. I also normally usually go to other conferences, but ECER is unique in that sense. In the sense that it's just not respect diversity, it's prompt diversity to be in conversation. And we have so many fantastic meeting, conversation with people, and also with other people that are not directly related, because normally you stay in your network, and this is the more or less. But I think this is I want to say thank you for that. Sorry, I had to say that, because also all the social part of the events, the poster, the meeting, the reception are great in that sense. Very well organized, and there's someone thinking about that in a very precise way, how people can be comfortable with that. So I think that for me is
And for your network, what does ECER mean for your network?
What impressed me in our network is participation. This participation, if you go, it's 9 o'clock here, and you can expect that some presentation will be a bit, there is not so many people around. It is not always packed. Always people doing interesting quality presentation. That's okay, we work on, try to work on that, to have quality presentation, but interesting comments, people that stay after the session to discuss and maybe to build a relationship, to build connection for future research project. That's great.
And this is my very last question. Is there anything else that you'd like to tell us today?
If I can say that, my hope is that the cultural capital that ESER helped build, you know, over all this year could help to improve our ability to exercise pressure on the way investment in education are managed in Europe nowadays. I think the investment in education, unfortunately, now are inadequate. So I hope that all the people that are working on that, and through us, we can have our voice heard better on that rooms, European rooms.
Fabio, thank you very much for sparing us some time today.
My pleasure. I thank you.